As a child in 1978, I liked two things, Battlestar Galactica and the Boston Red Sox. Over the years, my parents did get me a few of the different Battlestar Galactica toys. Some of them looked pretty realistic and were fun to play with. Others, not so much, and I don't remember ever seeing them in the show, kind of like the Stellar Probe. The Viper finally came out in 1978, and it still didn't quite fit the bill. Later on, other manufacturers started coming out with toys, and I picked them up as well. Finally, they were starting to look more and more realistic. And now, Eaglemoss has decided to come out with a Battlestar Galactica collection. And when I found out that they were doing the Battlestar Galactica collection in the Viper Mark I, I had to get my hands on it. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I got a package in the mail today from Eaglemoss that I've been waiting for. As I said at the beginning of the video, I've been a Battlestar Galactica fan for at least, for 40 years, because it's only been 40 years. It came out in 1978, and I'm talking about the original Battlestar Galactica, not the remake or the reimaging. I remember being 8 years old and having all the toys and really enjoying the show. And I was super excited to find out when Eaglemoss decided to come out with the models of Battlestar Galactica. So I was extremely happy when the package came today with the Viper Mark I, is what I'm assuming is inside here, because that's what they said it was going to come in. So together we're going to unbox it and see what Eaglemoss has done with the original series Battlestar models. This is going to be a model, I would assume, that had no digital print. So, pretty much they probably had to go by handwritten or drawn out descriptions of the ship versus having a digital model to go by. So without further ado, let's go ahead and open this. Packaged in the normal Eaglemoss packaging. Nice size box. Front of the box, you can see. I don't have any issue with the remake. In fact, I really enjoyed the remake, or I should call it the reimaging of it. But, there were some things that were different on the reimaging. And, growing up in the 70s and watching the original one, it was definitely different than what I had grown up with, though they did try to bring back a lot of, or some of the same things. But I understand, listen, things have changed, world has changed. Life has changed, and Cylons and things, they wanted to be able to tell a story that would reach us in the 2000s versus a story that would reach us back in the 70s. So I get that. I am going to collect the original series stuff, but I don't know if I'm going to collect the 2004 series stuff. And of course, we have the Eaglemoss book here. Viper Mark I, the TOS, the original series. Space Superiority Fighter. Linked laser torpedoes. Approximately 8.7 meters. Shows here. One of the things that I always wondered about, and if you go back and watch the original Battlestar Galactica movie, and in fact every model, it shows it the same way, but how did, after the original battle, when the Cylons attacked Caprica, Apollo tells his father, Adama, that he doesn't want him to go down to Caprica and that he'll fly him down in his Viper. Every version of the toy that I've ever had, I don't know where they would sit. I mean, they show it that when it's landed on Caprica, and maybe they'll show something in here, but I don't see how they could fit two seats. So if anybody has any ideas on how they could fit two people in here, please let me know. More pictures. Probably don't have a whole lot to go by. Viper variants. I do talk about a recon Viper. Some pretty good pictures of the Viper. Oh, and actually, there are some sketches here of probably what the Viper was going to look like. And I can tell you right now, as a 70s kid, I can tell that that and that were probably where Buck Rogers got their ships from, because those are very, very similar to how the Buck Rogers fighters came out. And I know they used a lot of the same footage in Buck Rogers that they used in the original Battlestar Galactica to save money. So if you ever go back and forth watching Buck Rogers and Battlestar Galactica, some of the space scenes and some of the battle scenes are identical because they are reused roles of the film. That would be something else that would be might be kind of cool, is to see a Buck Rogers someday, the Starfighters, come out in Eaglemoss. Though I don't know how many ships that they'd really be able to produce, but at least that one would be good. Here's a concept picture, and I remember seeing this when I was a kid. In fact, this picture here was probably on some of their promo stuff, you know, back in the early or the late 70s. Here. And then the next ship that comes out is the original Cylon Base Star. I did hear that the original Battlestar will be out, but that will probably be in the next, probably after the Base Star comes out. One thing that they don't do on the Battlestar catalogs that they do on the Discovery ones that I talk about is that they do kind of show what the next three or four on the Discovery line is going to be. But I don't think they've done that so much on the Battlestar line. Though, if you look at some of the recent news from Eaglemoss, they did show prototypes of the original Battlestar and the Base Star, as well as the Cylon Raider. But what you all are here for is to see what the Battlestar, or the Viper, looks like. Yeah, packaged really nice. Wow. That is a big model. This has a really nice weight to it. One of the laser cannons seems to be a little bit higher than the other, but that's easily fixable. One thing that Eaglemoss is tends to be doing with these type of fighter ships is that they make the cockpit window black. The canopy is black, and I would really like to see it more clear, and maybe even put a pilot in there, or to try to show off the inside of the cockpit a little bit better, like some of the plastic models does. I understand, you know, why they might not do that, you know, when there's some, you know, cost involved and intricacies of that. However, if they were to do that, maybe they could charge a little bit more for the model. But that being said, this has got a really nice weight to it. It's a really nice size ship. In fact, I get a measuring tape here. it's almost, that's about 11 inches long. So it is a really good size ship. And just to give you a little bit of an idea, you know, of the size. Does have a little bit of plastic. And of course, there's metal in here as well. But it does have a little bit of plastic. It does look weathered, so it does have a slight weathered look to it. The seams seem to be put into locations that the actual Viper seams might actually be, so they're blended in very nicely. Like I said, this side here might be just slightly higher as far as the laser cannon is concerned, but you probably will be able to kind of bend that down a little bit if it bothers you. Inside where the engines are, which I don't know if you're going to be able to see it or not in the video, but you can definitely see inside, there is detail inside the engines that give it the fans of the engines. Of course, in space, you don't need fans, but maybe when they're inside of an atmosphere, the fans would be something that the ship would use. All in all, I am very happy with how this looks. It seems like it's a very sturdy model. You know, I've had, as you saw at the beginning of the video, I've had every incarnation of Viper, I think, since 1978. I've had quite a few of them anyway. Some don't look anything like what I always have pictured or wanted the Battlestar Viper to look like. This one looks very much like how, you know, you would think that the Battlestar Viper would be. Very, very good. I would think that the center inside here would be hollow, though it does have a little cap on the front there. I would have thought that it would have been hollow going down into it, but I could be wrong. In fact, I think some of the pictures in the book also showed that it was hollow. But very nice. The other thing that you'll notice, you know, that the new Battlestar did, that this one did not do, is they did put some of the placards on the new Vipers, kind of like modern day fighters, whether it be the pilot's name, the do not step, you know, the blast, things like that, the number, something, you know, that lets you know that this is Apollo's Viper or this is Starbuck or Boomer's Viper. This does not have any of that on there because the original show didn't have any of that on any of their ships. You know, they just kind of knew who their whose ships was whose, I guess. You know, they didn't think like that, you know, back in the late 70s. I don't even think X-Wing fighters even had, you know, whose ship it was or whatever on there. Either that or maybe there's people who are just smarter and they know where not to step and where the blast is going to come out. Who knows? Also, there's no landing gear on these models. There shows where it should be. So this is in landing gear, you know, up mode, which is fine. All right, I'm going to go ahead and show you the bottom of the stand there. Pretty much goes together like any Eaglemoss type stand. See it on its stand. All right, guys, that's the Battlestar Galactica Mark I Viper. Please like, share, and subscribe. I've got noticed that my Star Trek Discovery Vulcan Corvette is on its way from Eaglemoss, as well as the Star Trek Discovery plaque. So those are both on their way. So those should be my next open boxes. Again, like, share, and subscribe. And feel free to ask me any questions if you're interested in buying one of these and have questions before you buy. I'd be happy to answer them for you. Until next time, we'll see you in the stars.